سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا طيبا مبارك فيه، نحمده جل وعلا ونستعينه ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونخلع من الحول والقوة إلا إليه، ولا نكفره ونخلع ونترك من يفجره، ونشهد شهادة عبد مؤمن أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركها على محجة بيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك، فصلوات ربي وتسليماته عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين، وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك ومنك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، فيا أيها المؤمنون، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله جل وعلا، فالتقوى هي مخافة الجليل، والعمل بالتنزيل، والرضا بالقليل، والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. After I praise Allah, the Creator, the Maker, the Shaker, the Giver, the Taker, I testify before your eyes, before your heart, before your spirit, before you, there is no God but Allah, the Creator. And I testify that Muhammad, peace be upon him, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the seal of all the prophets and messengers. I pray to Allah for continuous blessing unto him, unto his family, unto his companion, unto his follower, and unto you until the day of resurrection, the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonish us to have a piety in our heart and to come to him, to have the taqwa and to rush to him. He is the Creator and he is the one grant us everything in this life to live and enjoy, but be righteous. So, O believer, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called upon you on such day of assembly, the day of Friday, and said, Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, idha nudiya lissalati min yawm al-jumu'ati fasa'u ila dhikrillah wa dharul bay'a. Allah command us, when we hear the proclamation on the day of assembly, so we have to quick haste to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remember him and pour what we have in our heart before him. So he is the one to hear and to respond. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have the piety, have the taqwa in our heart. And the meaning of it is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything we do, in every act we present, in the dealing, in the wheeling, in the saying, that we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. No human to be equal in that fear but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to live our life by the revelation, by the sacred book that Allah the Majesty revealed to the heart of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And in order for you and for me to adhere, we have to learn. We have to spend some time with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قرأوا ما تيسر من القرآن. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all of us in our days, in our nights, not just only to read it as a worship, but to read it and understand it and translate it to our action. Muslims never ever fear other than Allah. Muslims are the title of justice. Muslims are the title of peace. Muslims are the title of equality. What we do, we say to the people the best. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. What we do, we avoid anyone to be subject to any transgressions by any Muslim. المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. the Muslim who is a people will be saved from his tongue and his hand. So we do not do any action to transgress against people, and we do not use our tongue to harm anyone, but you use it to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We use it to ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We use it to say good things to the people as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us. Allah said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. He didn't say, قُولُوا لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ حُسْنًا وَالْمُسْلِمِينَ حُسْنًا. He said, قُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Say to the people the good things that we have to say. If we do this, then you will be the governors of all these regions. If you do this, you will be the one that have the respect and honor by all the people, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in the Holy Quran. Those they follow the Prophet, peace be upon him. They command what's good and forbid what's bad, and they are going to be among those, they will be prosperous in the hereafter. You see the Muazzin, what he said? Hayya ala al-falah. Hayya ala al-falah. Falah is not success only. Falah is success and prosperity. This is what we join together to be prosperous, to be al-muflihun. Man hum al-muflihun? Let us see. It's not my word. It's Allah's word. So we have to learn the book, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all of us. Learn the book. So man hum al-muflihun? Who they are? بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ويحل لهم الطيبات ويحرم عليهم الخبائث ويضع عنهم إسرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم فالذين آمنوا به وعزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه أولئك هم المفلحون. We understand this verse. We are not the tail of nations, but we should be the head of nation as the Prophet, peace be upon him, did. You know, when the Prophet came to this Ummah in Mecca, they were the tail of all the nations. They used to have the amusements and play and gambling and all the above. When you look at the social sicknesses as we have today in the Muslim world, Churchill one day said, take the Quran from the Ummah, you will rule them. What happened? They took it from our hands. They took it from our schools. They took it from our life. We complain about them. We should complain about us, because we know what we have. Islam is not just only supplication and dua. Islam is action and translation to all what Allah said to us, to ourselves, to our families, to our neighbors, to our nation, and to the world. Those are successful in following the Prophet, peace be upon him. The Prophet commands us to follow the right thing and forbid the wrong things. And this news is not only new news, it's mentioned and stated in the Torah, the book of Jews, and in the Bible, the book of Christians. And those, they will believe in Allah, they will believe in the Prophet, and they follow the light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us, those are the prosperous people. What are we looking? Why we are worried? Allah, the Almighty said, لَهُ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمَنْ بَعْدُ. To Allah is the matters from the beginning and the end, and all what we have. We have to be optimistic, and we have to be content in following what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to all of us. Muslims, don't worry. The prophecy of the prophets is clear. And a prophecy to all of us, reread it in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, that if we do not follow the book of Allah, then the curse will come. And you know the fitna. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُسِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. That Allah is warning us. So you are looking at the news here and there and see what the Jews and all the Gulf people are doing. It's not new. It's all if you read the books. If we Muslims really be informed about what's going on. What's going on today been written in a book, came out of Washington, D.C. in 1997, Muslims. Read about these. Read about all the plans. But that's not the care and concern. The care and concern is we. Are we a real Muslims? If we are, then don't worry. Allah promise will prevail. So we follow Allah's revelation in our life and be content to what's coming our way, because it could be worse. And if we don't content, don't blame anybody but yourself. And be prepared, because all what we have is a day like today that Allah grant us to live in. We don't know about another hour, or we don't know about tomorrow. Tomorrow might come, but I might not be in this life. So that's what I have to be really mindful of, brothers and sisters. We have to be mindful of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all of us. I leave you with this message. Allah the merciful, Allah the wise, Allah the one who will change and challenge, Allah the one that his matter is between the kaf and the noon, and Allah will say, kun fayakun. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order. But what we have to do, we have to repent to Allah. We have to be sincerely a pure Muslim, adhere to good and forbid the bad, and then we'll follow what the Prophet, peace be upon him, said to all of us. We'll be among the successful. We'll be among the prosperous in this life. And those, they will enter the heaven, the first group, the group of the praising God. A group, we call him Al-Hamidun. So let us all together praise Allah. Let us all together say Alhamdulillah for everything. Let's praise Allah for what he gave you and gave me. And let us follow what the Prophet said. The Prophet said, At-ta'ibu min al-dhanb kaman la dhanba lah. Ud'u Allah wa antum muqinoon bil-ijabah. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على من اصطفى سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. Who said, in such day, on the day of assembly, you and I will have multiple reward by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking for the blessings of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Because the blessings on the Prophet will be the healer to all of us, will heal all of us. Because when you follow him and follow his teaching and follow his explanation and follow his step, we will be among the happiest and we will be among the prosperous people on the face of the earth. And then, and only then, they will be said to us, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. So let's put our hearts together and be among those they praise Allah Alhamidun. And let us be among those they pray as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command us to pray when he said, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alamin innaka Hamidum Majid. Oh Allah the merciful, oh Allah the creator, you know what we have in our heart. Nothing will be hiding from you, oh Allah. Oh Allah, guide our hearts to be a sincere, devoted Muslim to you. Guide our hearts to follow the step and the teaching of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So we'll be sincerely devoted to you and content, and everything comes our way. Oh Allah, have mercy on us. Have mercy on all the Muslims and everywhere in the world. Oh Allah, stop the bloodshed everywhere, here and there and everywhere, oh Allah. Oh Allah, guide us, guide our family, guide our community, guide our nations to be those among those that are successful and prosper. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wa tub alayna wa afina wa'fu anna wa ila ghayrika la takilna, ya Allah. Allahumma ij'alna muslimin lak mukhlisina fi dinina amilina fi sabili raf'i liwa'ika, ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma habna rahmatan mink. هب لنا رحمة منك علينا وعلى أهلينا. احفظنا واحفظ أهلينا واحفظ أبناءنا واحفظ المسلمين أينما كانوا يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأوصيكم بالصدقة فإنها تدخلكم إلى الجنة بإذن الله.